Hi everyone, welcome to WWE 2K23 Showcase Mode. So let's get right into it. I'm not sure if there's going to be a cutscene once I actually hit this, but we'll see.
On June 27th, 2002, I took my first steps towards the WWE ring. The first massive opportunity to realize a dream, a golden opportunity to make it, the world of sports entertainment, a chance to prove I belonged in the WWE universe. And I failed. But in that failure, in over a 20-year career, I've dedicated my entire life's work to three words. Never give up. Those who've heard that message and stood beside me, I'm forever indebted to your passion and support. I've had to work to earn my place in WWE history. That work led to Royal Rumble wins, title reigns, WrestleMania main events. You were there. From watching me as a young man, gritting his teeth in generic boots and tights, to the vast array of shirts, wristbands, ball caps, you've always been the driving force for what happens in our universe. A universe with larger-than-life performers like Stone Cold Steve Austin, Hulk Hogan, and the first superstar, Bruno Sammartino. Standing on the shoulders of these giants, trying to become a legend of my own. Let's get back to the ring. The same ring each and every WWE superstar gets to take that exciting walk to. There is a certain magic that occurs in that 20x20 square. A symphony conducted by the music, the fans, the cheers, the boos, and of course, the superstars looking to always rise to that occasion to capture the next golden ticket, the next opportunity. I began my journey in one of the most celebrated classes in WWE history. From my start until today, I've competed against some of sports entertainment's biggest superstars. Those who've defined generations of entertainment, culture, sport, those who've electrified crowds, those who've soared through the sky. Those who helped me become better at knowing who I was and what I was made of. And, you know, I did enjoy quite a bit of success, but with success comes setbacks. And I've done my fair share of celebrating, but many times I faced the agony of defeat. No one who has dedicated their entire life to WWE has been able to remain undefeated. But those words, that mantra to always try to be better, has reminded me to never give up. And in the end, I think I did all right. So while I'm honored that the good folks at 2K selected me to be their focus for the WWE 2K23 Showcase, I was hoping to share some of that spotlight, some of the best superstars I've ever stood across a ring from on a number of very special nights. So, we prepared a list. During this time, we're going to relive the nights where these fine and sometimes not so fine superstars managed to get the better of me. Maybe there was some underhandedness, and maybe some rules were broken, and maybe simply I just wasn't the best superstar in the ring that night. Regardless, through all these setbacks, I'd have to remind myself, never give up. These superstars and legends helped tell the story of not only my career, but of the WWE for the last 20 years. And they deserve as much recognition and celebration as I've received for any of my accomplishments. They managed to defeat me at the highest levels on the biggest stages. So now, with you stepping into their shoes, I'm looking to get those wins back. You can do your best and try to follow the objectives, but I think it'll take me roughly 5 moves to have you staring up at the lights. So are you good enough to follow in their footsteps? Can you keep from receiving an attitude adjustment? Can you even see me? Because while these superstars are proven greats, and while you may be, I think only one thing is true. You can't beat me!
Alright. So, oh crap, copyrighted music. Welcome to the 2K Showcase featuring John Cena, You Can't Beat Me. Winning is great, but completing objectives yields the biggest rewards. Merging from the match victorious will earn you match rewards and unlock the next match. Completing all of the objectives in each match will earn you objective rewards. mute the audio, so, anyway, this is the first match. Also, there might be, like, some scenes in that first, like, intro I might have to, like, cut out. But anyway, one of a kind, Rob Van Dam versus John Cena. RVD's mix of speed, agility, and a love for the hardcore made him difficult for anybody. Having a hostile crowd backing him up gave him a huge home ring advantage and made him nearly unbeatable. Alright, let's go.
Rob Van Dam, Mr. Monday Night, the whole effing show. Rob is an individual that showcased athletic ability and at the same time introduced the audience of sports entertainment to the word extreme. Rob beats to his own drum. His ability is second to none. What he can do in the air and his flexibility, it makes him one of a kind. And I think that theme song fits him very well. ECW One Night Stand in the famed Hammerstein Ballroom. The crowd was the best crowd I've ever performed in front of. They were all rooting for Rob Van Dam. The crowd was the show. We were just performing around them. This small group was so enthusiastic that it's a night I remember like it was yesterday. It was more than just Rob Van Dam versus John Cena. It was an underdog company versus the powerhouse that is WWE. It was something I've never experienced after that, and I don't know if I'll ever experience it. Even when it seems like the whole entire world is against you, if there was one fan still rooting for me in that crowd, I was going to fight for them. And I was going to fight for anyone cheering me on watching at home. Even in the most hostile environment, I wasn't going to abandon the people that had my back, and I was going to fight for them at ECW One Night Stand.
Alright. For help on completing objectives, go to your objectives checklist in the pause menu, okay? Alright, so, real quickly, there might be, like, some scenes. Like, if it does it like how it WWE 2K22 did, where, like, it shows a cutscene of the match and then, like, goes into the actual real match, I might throw that up. So, in any case, it's not that I want to do that, it's basically, like, YouTube copywriting this stuff, but in any case, let's do this. So I remember Rob started off really fast, trying to deal some big damage before I knew what was happening. Then he used a hammer throw to toss me to the floor like a sack of potatoes. Successfully attack, grapple, or dive at your opponent to cause big damage. While standing in front of opponent, press circle to grab them, and then hold circle L towards the ropes to strong iris whip the opponent to ringside. Okay. Oh, come on. There we go. Basic Thugonomics trophy. Alright, get up. Alright, come on. Wait, what are you getting, bro? hold on. Press circle, then hold that. Yeah, that's literally what I'm doing. There we go. He stayed on me, rocking me with two of those heavy combos of his. Alright, what are the combos? Okay. Right on the steel chair. Oh, heavy combo. Okay, I got it. Come on. Once we got back in the ring, I hoped to get a second to breathe, but Rob kept it moving by sending me into the ropes with an Irish whip. Okay. And Rob Van Dam gets clotheslined to the outside. And fans are chanting, "You can't wrestle," to John Cena. And John Cena on the top. Big dive to Rob Van Dam on the outside. Rob knew he needed to get back into the match and found a way with a diving moonsault from the top rope to the floor. He also connected with that corkscrew leg drop of his while I was across the barricade. While on the top turnbuckle, an opponent grounded in a supine position at ringside, press X to perform RVD's diving moonsault. Alright. There we go. Wait, what was it? X. There we go. All right, come on. Wait, is this it? I think it is. Yeah, let's go. When I finally got back to my feet, Rob Van Dam was waiting with a steel chair ready to attack me in the ring. When I was down, he brought the storm with a signature rolling thunder. Right, okay. I was hurt but not done. Rob Van Dam would grab me in the ring when I got to my feet looking for a front heavy grapple. Alright. And ooh, split leg moonsault, but John Cena counters. Oh, now, and John Cena with a DDT onto the steel chair, it looked like. And in for the pin, but feet on the ropes, and Rob Van Dam kicks out at two. Now John Cena putting the steel chair wedged between the turnbuckles. Oh, and launching Rob Van Dam straight into the steel chair. Kick out at two. Alright. I'd really hurt Rob with that slingshot. He knew he'd have to launch a dive attack from the top rope if he wanted the momentum back. Once he connected, Rob Van Dam once again tossed me to the floor with a hammer throw. He knew the match couldn't end out there. He followed me to ringside where he stung me with a light combo. While I was recovering, Rob Van Dam grabbed a table from the apron and set it up in the corner. There we go. Table. I got back in the ring and again Rob grabbed me and looking to set up another front heavy grapple. It was now or never for me. Alright. here we go. And Rob Van Dam drops the ropes. Well, now Cena arguing with the referee. Oh, I'm shoving the referee. Oh, clotheslining the referee. Wow. And Rob Van Dam was on the top, and now it looks like John Cena's gonna suplex him. On now, grabbing the steel stubs. On attacking them with the steel stubs. Another referee gets in here. And Rob Van Dam kicks out at two. Rob Van Dam grabs the ropes and gets tossed over the ropes. Oh, and now a masked superstar sends him into the table, John Cena. And now attacking the referee. And it is, oh, it's Edge. This is a long cutscene. It's probably the finish, honestly. Now Rob Van Dam gets back to the top. And a frog splash. Rob Van Dam trying to revive the referee. Oh, and here's Paul Heyman. And Rob Van Dam wins. Awesome. All right, so we unlocked, ooh, Word Life, trophy. So it looks like ECW One Night Stand Arena, the original WWE Championship, basically the WWE Championship that was in this match. We got Rob Van Dam, and You Can't See Me. Not sure why that's still locked, because I did everything. Yeah, but anyway, let's try to see what happens when I actually, actually lose. Hey, great job, you've earned a John Cena's attire from ECW One Night Stand 2006. Now go complete all the objectives in match 8 to unlock the model. Oh, and the next one's gonna be Kurt Angle versus John Cena. Alright.
Rob Van Dam, Mr. Monday Night, the whole effing show. Rob is an individual that showcased athletic ability and at the same time introduced the audience of
Alright, let's lose. And copyrighted music.
Here is your winner, and still the WWE Champion, John Cena!
Oh, the fans didn't really like that. Oh, and they even got security because nobody wanted them to win. Yeah, I wonder how to actually unlock that then. Alright, well next up, it'll be Kurt Angle versus John Cena at SmackDown 2002, June 27th. Kurt Angle exemplified excellence throughout his career, a master on the mat with a counter for any attack in the gold medal to back it all up. His open challenge on SmackDown is answered by a brash newcomer fueled by ruthless aggression. Is he truly the prototype of the future, or will Angle ruin John Cena's arrival? Alright. Well, anyway, that will be next time. I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you for the next one.